We want to determine the dimensions of a rectangle bounded by the semicircle y equals the square root of 16 minus x squared that would maximize the area. So here's an example of what the rectangle might look like. Let's see if we can determine the dimensions of this rectangle. The length from here to here would be equal to y, but y is bounded by the function, so the length of this side here would be equal to the square root of 16 minus x squared. Now looking at the horizontal distance here, the distance from the origin to this corner would be x, and therefore the length on the other side would also be equal to x. So the length of this entire side would be 2x. So the dimensions for this rectangle are 2x by the square root of 16 minus x squared, which means the area of this rectangle would be the product of these two dimensions. So we'd have 2x times the square root of 16 minus x squared, which I'm going to write as the quantity 16 minus x squared to the 1/2 power. And we want to maximize this area, which means we'll have to determine the critical numbers of the function by determining where the derivative of this function is either equal to 0 or does not exist. And looking at this function, we'll have to apply the product rule in order to find the first derivative. So we'll let this equal the first function, and we'll let this equal the second function. So the derivative is going to be equal to the first function, 2x, times the derivative of the second function, which is going to require the chain rule. So the inner function will be 16 minus x squared, we'll call that u. So we can think of this as u to the 1/2. The derivative of u to the 1/2 with respects to x would be 1/2 times u to the negative 1/2, but u is 16 minus x squared, times u prime, which is negative 2x, plus the second function, 16 minus x squared to the 1/2, times the derivative of the first function, which would be 2. Now let's work on simplifying this. This 2 and this 2 would simplify out, so it looks like we'd have negative 2x squared, and then this has a negative exponent, so we'll move it down to the denominator. We'll have the quantity 16 minus x squared to the 1/2, plus, here we're just going to have 2 times the quantity 16 minus x squared to the 1/2. We'll go ahead and put this over 1, because what we're going to do now is combine these two fractions. We're going to do that by multiplying by the least common denominator, which would be the quantity 16 minus x squared to the 1/2. So multiply this fraction by 16 minus x squared to the 1/2 over itself. When we do this, notice how we now have a common denominator. We have 16 minus x squared to the 1/2 in the denominator. Our new numerator is going to be negative 2x squared plus 2 times, now these bases are the same, so we'll add the exponents. We'll just have the quantity 16 minus x squared to the first. And now we can distribute here and combine like terms. Oops, this is a prime. So a prime is going to be equal to, here we have negative 2x squared, and then another negative 2x squared, that'll be minus 4x squared, plus 32 all over our denominator. Now we want to know where the derivative does not exist or where it's equal to 0. Now looking at the denominator, we can see it's not going to exist when x is equal to 4. If x is equal to 4, the height of the rectangle would be 0. So we can disregard that and only determine where this is equal to 0. And this is only going to equal 0 when the numerator is equal to 0. So if we set the numerator equal to 0 and try to solve, let's factor out negative 4. We're left with x squared minus 8 equals 0. So this will equal 0 when x squared equals 8. So we can take the square root of both sides. The two critical numbers are x equals plus or minus 2 square root 2. So these are the two critical numbers. But because one of the sides has a length of 2x, We know x can't be negative, otherwise that would produce a negative area. So the only critical number that we have is x equals 2 square root 2. So this means that at this x value, there may be a maximum or minimum function value, which does represent our area. There's a couple ways of doing that. We could either use the first derivative test or the second derivative test. But looking at our first derivative here, I really don't want to determine the second derivative of this because it would take some time. So for this example, I think we'll just look at it graphically. But what we're hoping to determine is to the left of 2 square root 2, the function will be increasing. And then to the right of 2 square root 2, we hope the function will be decreasing, so that this verifies we'd have a relative maximum at x equals 2 square root 2. Let's determine the decimal approximation for 2 square root 2. It's approximately 2.8. I've already entered in the original area function, so let's go ahead and take a look at the graph. And notice that about 2.8, right in here, it does appear we have a relative maximum, and the function is increasing and then decreasing. Therefore, we're going to go ahead and assume that at x equals 2 square root 2, we will have a relative maximum. So let's go ahead and determine the dimensions of this rectangle as well as the maximum area. So to do that, remember the dimensions were 2x by the square root of 16 minus x squared. So let's evaluate these two expressions. So if x is 2 square root 2, we'd have 2 times 2 square root 2, which would be 4 square root 2. And then for the square root of 16 minus x squared, we'd have 16 minus 2 square root 2 squared. Well, 2 square root 2 squared is equal to 8. So 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. So we have the square root of 8, which is 2 square root 2. So the dimensions of the rectangle that would maximize the area would be 4 square root 2 units by 2 square root 2 units, which means the maximum area would be the product of these two, which would be 4 square root 2 times 2 square root 2 square units. So 4 times 2 is 8, square root 2 times square root 2 is 2, so the maximum volume would be 16 square units.